Yes, children, what we have seen previously, based on objectives of cultivation, agriculture is divided into two types, subsistence agriculture and commercial agriculture. What is subsistence agriculture? Just now we have seen the agriculture, type of agriculture which is made to meet just their self needs, just their needs. And that is again two types, primitive subsistence and intensive subsistence, and that is the first type. Coming to the second type, what is commercial agriculture? So commercial agriculture means the agriculture particularly which is made based on the market oriented means for which crops there is more demand in the market, such crops only produced in the fields, which actually give more profits, which actually give more income to the farmers. Such type of crops are grown particularly in a commercial agriculture. So in order to have more productivity, more production, generally farmers use high yielding varieties. High yielding varieties means high yielding seeds which give more yielding. They use more fertilizers, they use more pesticides, and even they adopt modern farm techniques in order to get more yielding. Why? Because in order to get more income. So that is what commercial agriculture. Again, commercial agriculture is of different types. Plantation agriculture comes, extensive commercial grain farming comes, mixed farming and dairy farming, horticulture and Mediterranean agriculture. In this way, different types are there. We will see one by one slowly. Now coming to the plantation agriculture. So what is plantation agriculture? By whom it was introduced first? Particularly, the plantation plantation agriculture was used by colonial rulers in colonies, tropical and subtropical colonies. By whom? Particularly, those are English, French and Dutch. Colonial rulers, they introduced these type of plantation crops in the tropical and subtropical colonies. And even you know that India is also one of the colonies of British. So in our country also, these people only introduced this kind of crops. So what is plantation agriculture? The plantation agriculture is a method of agriculture where a single crop is used, single crop is grown in a large area. What is plantation agriculture means? A single crop is grown in a large area. That means you don't find other crops. In large area you can see the same crop. Such kind of crop is called, such type of agriculture is called plantation agriculture. What are the major crops? Particularly, that is tea, coffee, rubber, sugarcane and cocoa. In this way, you can see plantation crops. That is tea, coffee, rubber, sugarcane, cocoa. And in some books they have given banana also, plantain also you can see. In such a way, plantation, these are the major plantation crops. And it's a type of commercial farming. Commercial farming means in order to get money only, such type of crops are grown and single crop is grown, and the crops which are grown, those crops are particularly used as raw materials in most of the industries. For example, take tea industry. So tea is used to make tea powder. Coffee industry. Coffee is used as a raw material to make coffee powder. And also rubber, different rubber industry you can see. Rubber is used as a raw material. And in our country, the Kerala, which is a very important state for producing a rubber. Coffee, Karnataka is the largest producer of coffee. Tea, Assam is the main producer of tea. And sugarcane, Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh are the largest sugarcane growing states. So, the crops which are grown in plantation crops, those are used as raw materials for different industries, and most of the processing industries are well connected with all types of transportation, particularly airways and also roadways. Particularly in such a way, plantation crops play very important role. Even our country also earning very good foreign exchange currency by exporting that is why coffee, tea, even rubber also. And India is one of the largest producers of tea in the world. So that is what plantation agriculture. Now coming to the extensive commercial grain farming. Extensive commercial grain farming. So here we produce a particular grain in a large way, in a large area. That's why here we use large sized farms. Particularly extensive commercial grain farming is completely associated with the wheat and other crops also grown. Oats are grown, barley is also grown, and corn is also grown in this extensive commercial grain farming. Particularly this farming is associated with which crop? Means wheat. And which type of farms are used? Means large sized farms are used. And where it is produced? Particularly in Europe, in steppes it is produced, in Canada prairies, in Argentina pampas, in Australia downs. So you may get doubt, what are these? So these are the grassland names in different parts of the world. Grassland names. So in Europe the grasslands are called steppes, in North America particularly prairies, in South America those are called pampas, particularly Argentina, and even in case of Australia downs. So these places are very famous for extensive commercial grain farming. And even in previous classes I have mentioned already, the prairies are called granaries of the world. I told you already what the prairies are called, granaries of the world. That means those prairies are producing more and more grain to the world, and most of the people are meeting their needs by importing such a grain. And that is extensive commercial grain farming. Now coming to the mixed farming. What is mixed farming means? Particularly whenever you observe the crop cultivation as well as animal husbandry simultaneously, side by side, such type of farming is called mixed farming. That means if a farmer does only cultivation of crops, that is called, not called mixed farming. So one side he rear animal, he rear cattle, another side he do cultivation also, another side he do agriculture, particularly he grow crops. Such type of farming is called a mixed farming. That means he mixes both the activities. One side he produce crops, another side he rear animal, particularly cattle. Such type of farming is called mixed farming. Particularly mixed farming you can see in the Northwest Europe and also Eastern North America, not the entire North America, only Eastern North America. So Northwestern Europe and particularly these parts in Europe, these parts, this is Europe, this is Northwest part of Europe, and Eastern North America, so these parts, only these parts. North America, these parts, eastern parts of North America. And while mentioning the grasslands, I did not show you Argentina. In South America, you can find Argentina here, one of the largest countries in South America. This is Argentina in South America. Remember, this is Argentina. In Argentina, also, that is, that particularly grasslands are called pampas. I mentioned already. In Argentina, the grasslands are called pampas. Particularly in South America, grasslands are called pampas. So there are other names also, but here they have mentioned pampas. So in Argentina, you can see extensive commercial grain farming. But mixed farming, I told you, eastern parts of North America, northwestern part of Europe. So in this way, the mixed farming is done. One side, they use they grow crops, another side they rear cattle. And one more important thing, in order to maintain fertility of the soil, they use two methods. Very important point, remember, rotation of crops and intercropping. Rotation of crops means they don't grow a single crop, if they go this time wheat, next time they go for paddy. In such a way they rotate the crop, they change the crop in order to maintain the fertility of the soil. Even intercropping also, intercropping means having other crops also in the same crop. For example, in our Anantapur district, there is groundnut. In groundnut, you may see in the middle of all the farms, in the middle of groundnut, you can see red gram also, Bengal gram also, horse gram is grown in different way. So they grow red gram, horse gram, particularly red gram, Bengal gram, green gram, they grow. Such type of cropping is called intercropping. And here in case of mixed farming, they use large sized land holdings, and they used modern methods of agriculture in order to have more yielding. That's why in mixed farming the yield per person is low, yield per hectare is more. Why? Because people are less, people, the number of laborers are used less. And coming to the dairy farming, other type is dairy farming. Other three types are, I will mention briefly. Other three types are, number one, dairy farming. And next type is Mediterranean agriculture. Mediterranean agriculture. And third type is horticulture and truck farming. Mediterranean type of agriculture. Horticulture and truck farming. Now first one, dairy farming. So what is dairy farming? Dairy farming is nothing but that having cattle very near to the fields. Whenever you grow cattle in a large scale along having little cultivation, such type of farming is called dairy farming. And particularly this dairy farming is done in a commercial way in most parts of the world. Those they have mentioned here few parts, particularly the North and Western Europe. You can see North and Western Europe. See, this is North and Western Europe. And next important one is Canada, Southeastern Australia. Canada, but this is Canada. So also you have to remember for map pointing, Canada and Southeastern Australia. This is Southeastern Australia. Okay, Southeastern Australia. And one more, New Zealand and Tasmania. See, in the world map you see the Tasmania here. This is Tasmania and this is New Zealand. Tasmania and New Zealand. Okay, so this is dairy farming. Dairy farming is nothing but rearing cattle with the having farms. Farms are very near to the cattle. And milking is done by using machineries. Milking is done by using a machinery. So that is dairy farming. Now coming to the Mediterranean agriculture. So Mediterranean agriculture is other type of agriculture. Particularly this type of agriculture is associated, you can observe, around the Mediterranean Sea. Where you observe this Mediterranean agriculture? Around the Mediterranean Sea. I have to show you where the Mediterranean Sea is here. This is the Mediterranean Sea. Mediterranean Sea is exactly between the Europe and Africa. The countries around the Mediterranean Sea are, see, observe, Spain, France, Italy, Austria, Greece, Turkey, and Syria, all these countries come under Mediterranean Sea. Understood? So this is what in what way the countries you observe, even these are important for map finding. So around the Mediterranean Sea you can find such type of agriculture, and particularly you can see that is viticulture. Viticulture or other important thing they have mentioned, grapevine cultivation is done along the Mediterranean Sea. So the wine which is produced here, those are high quality wine which is very famous throughout the world by using grapes. In the preparation of such a wine, they use more grapes. That's why this region is very famous for such kind of the production of that wine. So Mediterranean agriculture, what we observe here, particularly viticulture, observe this. And coming to the horticulture, so horticulture is associated with the cultivation of fruits, vegetables and also flowers. Fruits, vegetables and flowers, they used to produce high quality of fruits, vegetables and flowers in case of horticulture. So horticulture is a separate course, and the people can opt this in order to have training. And particularly tulips are grown in a large way, in a large scale, particularly in the country Netherlands. Observe the country Netherlands. Netherlands, you can see very near to this Netherlands, you cannot observe here. It's a very small country which is very near to Germany and also France and also very near to Belgium. Netherlands, you cannot observe unless you observe if you see Netherlands, particularly in our Europe, you can find the borders of the Netherlands. So Netherlands, tulips are grown in a commercial way, large scale. That is called horticulture. Now coming to the truck farming. What is truck farming means? The fresh vegetables, if fresh vegetables are grown, and if those are transported to the near urban areas, and such kind of farming is called truck farming. So what is done in truck farming? Fresh vegetables are grown, those are transported freshly to the near urban centers. Such kind of farming is called truck farming. And even in farms itself, you can see some facilities like the freezing facilities and also cold storage facilities. Such facilities you can observe in case of truck farming. And through truck farming, they can easily transport vegetables freshly to the urban areas. And particularly, those have to be transported within 24 hours. That's why such farms are very near to such kind of urban centers. Such kind of farming is called truck farming. Okay, in the remaining classes, what are the different types of crops? What are food crops? What are commercial crops? And which type of climate is required for growing such type of crops? We will see that in the coming class. Thank you.